declared the first war that will bring in everybody in the world, pretty much. It's not quite everyone. I don't think India has anything that is sending stuff against us yet. All the way over to the Hafsids. Which are near India, but not quite India. Haven't lost any major sieges yet. Bringing a full force of 40,000 troops to bear on this county in... on the army in this county of Atianides. And go deal with the Wessex army. Split the army in half. Don't like doing that. That would be a bad idea. Move those armies to different places. Because one has crap for bringing true faith and salvation to others is among the holiest duties. Therefore, we ask you to construct a new church in your land so your subjects may have somewhere to say prayers and worship. Decline. I don't like building churches. Wait 5 days and then assault. Captured somebody. 16,000 is the steer mark. Yeah. All sucks. 7.5k. Don't want to do it, but I'm going to have to. Split the troops. Then go up to Steermark, and these guys can assault immediately. I need to be wary of where I send my troops, or else I could be facing a ton of attrition, which I'm probably going to be anyway. 20,000 there. Yeah. Okay. Days to assault through that. That's significantly less. I'm going to keep 10,000 back here, I think. Going in for a 15,000 on 10,000. I should probably put some commanders in charge. There's an organizer available. Flanker. With the organizer in the center. That guy. Oh, wait. No, let's go with the flat terrain expert in the middle. Okay, we're gonna win that battle, it looks like. Hopefully. Please. Let's assault that real quick. Slain somebody, apparently. 3 days. Assault. 70% war score. What is our... We're 86. So at the end of this war... Should be enough. Let's go into Salzburg, I think. We should be able to win that siege. More people joined. More people continue to join. Actually won. More people are attacking into us, it looks like. Nine days before we can assault in Salzburg. I don't like the idea, but I'm going to anyway. Go up there and try to assault into that low attrition territory. That's probably going to be the move that loses me this war, isn't it? 91%. Please tell me he wants out. No. Of course, we probably have to get to 99. Thousand. 20,000. We'll go to Fejer, or Feher, or however you pronounce it. One day on the assault on that church. Two on the city. One on the second church, and he wants out. Surrender. And I'm going to go against my normal thing and disband everything now. I usually don't like to disband in enemy lands, but I feel like that was necessary. So, let's re-raise the Holy Order, who only lost about 2,000 in that, and the Varangian Guard, who lost... Okay, so that's my cataphract. Varangians lost about 1,000. And I have another piece of land that I need to give away to a good Greek Orthodox person. And by good, I mean any. Who's young-ish. We'll transfer it to that one. That's not who I wanted. Zaclumia. When did I acquire the Kingdom of Italy? 900. So I still have 7 more years before I can do that. But guess what? That's not the order of business right now. The order of business is man the Great Schism. We've got the 2,000 piety, we got our religious, our moral authority up to 93.8, which we didn't even need to do, apparently. the Bishopric of Constantinople, County of Antioch, Bishopric and County of Constantinople, Antioch, Jerusalem, Alexandria, and Rome are all held by Orthodox. And now, so where are the Catholics still? I want to focus in on that part of the map religiously, because things are about to change. Basically what this does is it makes Catholic a heresy. So the Great Schism saw the Christian branch, Christian Church divided into two branches, but if all five of the Episcopal sees of the Pentarchy could be restored under Roman rule and the Orthodox faith, there may be a chance to finally reunite Christendom. And what this does is it gives every Catholic ruler the option to switch to Orthodox. Great Schism ended. At last, the Eastern Schism between the Western Catholic Church and the Eastern Orthodox Church has been mended. With the spread of Orthodoxy and the reunification of the Pentarchy, including the rival Episcopal See of Rome, the Catholic faith now holds little sway over the people of Europe. There will be those who still cling to it, but they will be few in number, and the Pentarchy can once more claim universal rule over all of Christendom. God be praised. Catholic religion becomes a heresy of the Orthodox faith, and I will be known as the saint. So it'll change me from the holy to the saint. And so basically a bunch of people decided that they wanted to convert to Orthodoxy, and their counties along with them, I guess. I didn't know that that did that. But there's still quite a lot of Catholics that held out. It's surprising. Including, okay, maybe not. Maybe there weren't as many Catholics as I thought. All Catholic heresies are also now Orthodox heresies as well. And there's a dangerous faction. Part of that probably comes from disbanding the troops in foreign territory. Send our a gift to our Mysticos. And anyone else we can cheaply get out of the factions. Georgia? Yeah. Don't think that's quite enough. Can award him the title of... Antipatros, or Antipatos. My brother, how much for him? Eh. Quite a bit, but worth it, maybe. And he should be able to get out of it as well. I'm now tempted to leave the community of St. Basil, because I was actually thinking about becoming celibate. To get my piety up, but we didn't need it. So we're now Basilius and Alexandros II, the saint of the Byzantine Empire. So, how many rulers did... I think it was only, what, two? Two emperors of our dynasty, and we've mended the Great Schism. The next ruler should be the one to restore the Roman Empire, because all we need is one more holding. I could do it as this guy, but I don't like to have the same guy do both, because then he'll also be the glorious, and I'd like to have two different people. For that, the guy will need 8,000 prestige, I think. Right? Oh, only 3,000. 8,000 is, I guess, the creating custom empire. I could search for a smith to see if I can make some crown jewels for myself or something. But I think it's fitting that this guy compose a book. Council, I yell, making... Oh wait, I'm a lunatic. So, this could be the mad ravings of that crazy guy who amended the Great Schism. Council, I yell, making some courtiers scurry away from me, while others approach slowly. I am their Basilius, after all. It is time we talk about how to best preserve my ideas for our descendants. They nod and exchange nervous glances while I consider my decision. What should be my legacy? I will be tackling the complexity of war, or something along those lines. You choose a martial thing theme. It should be about the intricacies of relationships. Diplomacy theme. Something in honor of God or something educational, learning. Shall chronicle my family history, of course. Glory to the House of Constantinus. You choose to choose a theme not relating to any particular attribute. Makes sense for Saint to go with something in honor of God. Hoping that some people will leave this faction. Our troops are reinforcing, so people, it's now no longer dangerous. And I'm going to take the Holy Sepulchre and go deal with these raiders over. Created the Duchy of Albania, probably going to destroy it. Maybe not. ...99.2% threat. I told Constantinus to stay at home, but just as I finished purchasing my gift to him, I turn around and see him trying to hide from me. The surprise is ruined. I can't blame him, or I'll grab him by the ear and have a serious talk. We'll go with I can't blame him. Peasant revolt for Toledo. I want to see their empire collapse. They're gaining 0.287 decadence per month, and when the decadence revolt happens, their realm is going to fall apart. I want to... Okay, so he is a known murderer. He is trying to kill somebody. He's raised his flag in revolt. What do I get from writing a book? Okay, with the help of their scribes, this character is currently working on a piece of literature. Not too helpful in the description. They've got 800 troops. Go deal with these guys now. I guess I'll take the Varangian Guard and go deal with this guy. Spania has inherited a mosque. We've got a disease in our realm. Adrianopolis specifically. Do I want to close the gates? Well, the disease is already here. Going to try to shut the gates. Send these guys in. She should end her plot. She doesn't want to end her plot. Cyrus, King of Italy, okay. Let's get the... Guess we don't have access to the... this guy anymore. Oh, he decided to remain Catholic. Or, he has always been Catholic. Ah. Still, why can't I get him to lead my troops? I have no clue. Won that battle. Let's go back to Gaeta, where we will deal with another set of troops. He hired some guys. Apparently, yes. Assault that? Okay, that was the trade post. Bring these guys to Gaeta. And assault. 58%. Faithful and trusted hunting dog has finally taken his last breath. Long has he served you since you first received him as a puppy. I can build a pyramid for him. Was that always there, or is that because I'm a lunatic? That's a lot of money to spend on a pyramid for a dog. You know what, we're a little eccentric, and by a little I mean we're insane, but he deserves a funeral. News from China. Emperor Zhi Mingzong, the Chinese son of heaven, has died and been succeeded by Zhi Shizong. Like his predecessor, the emperor is known to believe in an open China. Apparently, he takes a special interest in eunuchs, but frowns on Latin Iberian cultures. Okay. Can ask for a boon, maybe. I'm in seclusion, so I can't really do anything with that. With the Emperor of China. Let's do that. He's a traitor, we can revoke that. And I'll give it away to somebody properly Greek. Disband those guys, take these guys back to Constantinople, and disband the fleet. Is there anyone in Italy who's still Catholic? Anyone count or higher, I mean. Doesn't look like it. And, you know, like, I mean, also my subjects, but... Anything in Greek converted to Greek yet? A couple things. Some stuff in the Middle East too. I've been severely wounded for a long time now. Let's seek treatment for my illness because I am... Also, I also have the Great Pox. Your court physician, Ecumenical Patriarch Nicephorus, has come to see you and offers treatment for your illness. He explains that let's go with something experimental. Try to lose Great Pox. And we get successful experimental treatment again. Alright. When does my son turn 12? 19th of June. We need a new steward. probably go with somebody who is considered a powerful vassal, even though he might not be the best. Jerusalem or Bulgaria. They both dislike me. Alright. I'd like to make some of these titles, but at the same time, I don't want to. Because that involves... Oh, my vassal declared a holy war for Tripolitania and also one for Kabylia. If they win both of those, I could pretty much take the Kingdom of Africa as well. Of course, this guy will probably just create it. Which is fine. Like, I have no problem with that. Anyone else we can imprison yet? She won't end her plot, of course. But I'm going to save the creation of titles for, somebody died. I'm going to save the creation of titles for the next character because he will be the one reforming the Roman Empire. I also need to keep my eye out for rebellions, Sunni uprising, and Azarka. Can I get maybe an army? Take them to Madaba. Can I build anything else in my hospital? I really hate the disease thing. No, we need more tech, and I'm not investing in any more tech until our capital is in Rome again. Won't be for a while, because there are some things that I'm going to do still that are going to be a little bit unorthodox. Cornered and slain on the battlefield, he fought bravely right until the end. Chancellor. Despot of Trebizond. He is kind of crap at spy mastery. What is he good at? Anything? Actually, he's not too bad. 13 intrigue isn't necessarily terrible. He is a really bad man. That guy is a really bad magistros, though. I mean, literally anyone would be better. Let's switch my magistros with my... I can't actually, can I? Actually, I can, if I go to the other guy. Really? Radomir's host has decided to attack the Brotherhood of the Holy Sepulchre. I don't know why, but they have. My son needs a final education, and I want to assign a different guardian than myself, actually, because I want them to be diligent, because I don't think I am. I'm not. A diligent character can actually intercede in his education and possibly make him diligent. And instead of the normal traits that fussy is listed as becoming, like every trait has something that else that it can turn into that is an intervention trait that, and I'm not sure what all of them are. I know that fussy, however, is definitely diligent, and so the guardian has to have that in order for them to you know what? No, I think I will maintain my the education of my son. You could become patient, greedy, or paranoid, though, which will suck for the paranoid and patient would be good. The others not greedy, not so much. So, we'll have to see how his education goes. Hopefully, he gets shrewd. Like my father. But that we'll have to wait and see on. Can I get any more retinue? I can, just one though. Move them in with the others. And I'm going to end the episode.